Hey everyone, welcome back to the Preset Biz channel. Today we're going to be doing part two of the Tell It To My Heart Medusa remake. So in the last video we did the verses and the build, and so this is the result of the last video. So we're now going to dive straight into the drop production and wrap up this remake. So the first part of the drop production I wanted to focus on was the bass line, and I've grabbed this preset called Hypnotize, which is a really short decayed sound, but this is perfect to do these kind of minimal repeat bass stabs, and this is what they sound like on their own. So it's obviously really minimal MIDI, but we kind of filled this up with various sounds throughout the whole project. We're then going to add this Good Boy sound from Piano House Volume 1, and this is such a sick sound to that. And this is the MIDI we're playing for it. And the processing is equally as simple because all I've got is a kickstart, which is following the main master kind of amount of kickstart. And then alongside that, I've also layered it with the tom pattern that we did in the last video. So these are just occasional tom hits that kind of sit with the bass. So the next sound I'm going to address is this kick, which I grabbed from Car Music Volume 2. This just felt like the perfect amount of top end and kind of character to just add a lot of punch to the whole drop. So we've then got a return of one of the sounds in the previous part. So this is that retro kind of pad sound, and this is just playing a single note on this section here. And then the next sound we're going to take a look at is this weird distorted lead sound, which was actually really hard to create, but this is how it sounds. It was really hard to make this sound because it's quite like a detuned synth with all sorts of things going on with the resonance, so that's kind of being modulated in the sound as well. But what I used for this was a synth called Return, which you can get in Car Music Volume 4. And like I said, I've kind of tweaked little things like distortion here and then also the shape here on the envelope, so it's kind of like a slow opening filter. Processing's quite minimal. We've got a little bit of dry being taken away and then loads of wet, so it's kind of a background element almost. So we've then got some claps here where I've taken the same one that we used in the previous part, and then I've also layered in this new one here. This just adds a nice amount of kind of smackiness to the whole clap. And then our drums were just bussing everything and then CLA compressing it, so it kind of glues all the elements together nicely. So as we head into the second half of the drops, we've got a load of old elements being introduced but with different MIDI. So this is the reintroduction of the Medusa sound. And these sounds consist of the Snake Lady and Home presets, which we did in the last part, so you can go and check that out if you want to see how we made those. We're then going to reintroduce the strings, playing the exact same notes, just being held throughout the whole drop, but with a bit of sidechain, so it's kind of ducking alongside the rest of the elements. We've then got this like weird choiry lead pad sound, which is a really slow swelling sound, and it sits in the background because of the processing we've got on it. And the preset's called Home, so what I've done on the tweak in here is just kind of added a bit more detune. And I kind of tweaked the fine tune a little bit so it sits a little bit off the pitch, just to give you that weird nostalgic kind of vibe to the whole sound, if that even makes any sense. But as you can see, we've also got a slow opening here with the envelopes where I've just kind of tweaked the attack times. So here's that processing I spoke about. So we've got no dry, we've just got full wet, and then we've got kickstart as well doing the same. We're then reintroducing all of the hi-hats from the previous part, but then we've got some open hi-hats playing every single note basically. So the nice thing about this is you've got a really constant in-your-face hi-hat, but then you've also got some nice kind of variant layers going underneath. I've then thrown the kick back in, and as you can see, we've got like a little double kick effect going on here. And then our claps are back in here, and then we've also got the retro chord stab sounds again. And then we're reintroducing a bunch of downlifters and noise exhausts to kind of really fill up the whole top end in this part. And then we've got like a triple crash as well, which just marks the second part. So that's the entirety of the production for this Medusa Tell It To My Heart remake. If you guys want to see how we did all of this production here, you can go and check that in the previous part. But let us know what you thought of this one and what you want to see in the next videos. But for now, we're going to go and check everything back to back and see how close it was.